I go on too many dates, but I can't make them stay.
Welcome back, everyone, to Morning After. It's 10:22 here on this Monday morning, June 15th. Good to have you here with us.
We are talking about not melting down on this Monday. We, you know, this is just our way of working some free therapy into the show for us and for all of you. So for Don't Have a Meltdown Monday, we bring in Leigh Richardson, who's a licensed professional counselor and founder of the Brain Performance Center. Good morning, Leigh.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Oh, we're so glad. We are so needing this right now. So here's the thing. Often when we have times of stress, like say you're working towards graduation and you have finals, or you're trying to get a child through their senior year, there's an end in sight to that stress. We know it's coming and we work toward it. And we know there's going to be some reprieve. Right now, this feels a little bit like there is not much reprieve, and we don't know when the uncertainty of the coronavirus is going to end. So how do we manage that?
Well, I think the most important thing is to stay in the moment. I saw a statistic that 80% of us are either lost in the past or worrying about the future. Mm. We need to stay present, stay in the moment, and focus on what you can control, not on what you can't control.
It's interesting too, isn't it, Leigh, when we talk about mental health, because the point of our conversation with you is to talk about how to keep a check on our mental health, how to overcome any mental health issues that we're having. And yet, let's be honest, it's an issue that's already underserved in this country. Mm. We have gaps in our mental health care, mental health programs. There's a stigma attached to admitting that you might be in a mental health crisis. This is just compounding upon it, is it not?
It is, and you know, you make a really good point. I wrote a book, Turn Your Brain On to Get Your Game On, for one reason, for people to know it's okay to not be okay. Because we get shameful. We don't want to admit that we have issues, and we all have mental issues at some point in our life.
Mm-hmm. So the Kaiser Family Foundation did this tracking poll where they looked at physical health versus mental health, and it said very few Americans have experienced a decline in physical health. However, 4 in 10 of us say that we've noticed a decline. So what I see from that is probably a lot of people who have never felt like they've needed mental health help are now in that space. Ron and I both have said before, we're on the regular.
Oh,
you
yeah.
We check in with professionals, but a lot of people never have. So how do they kind of delve into that and get comfortable with saying, I need some help?
I think it's hard to do. And you know, every day we have positive and negative events that go on in our life, and we tend to pay more attention to the negative. Research shows that we have 3 times more positive than we do negative. And I think just paying attention to what are you paying attention to, and how much attention are you paying to it? Because you have to be your own self-check. And when you notice, wow, I really am focusing on the negative, maybe I need to talk to a friend, maybe I need to talk to a professional. But to get that out of my head, I need to talk about it.
Yeah, that's true. And I think we have Thankful Thursday here because we want people to take at least one day a week to think about what's working in my life, what am I thankful for? And that may in and of itself be a cure for the problem of anxiety. Leigh Richardson, thank you for joining us from the Brain Performance Center. We really do appreciate it.